when it comes to social media, people are always asking me, what's the ROI? What's the return on investment? And then some people are just kind of naturally come to an assumption, duh, it's sales, it's conversion, it's traffic. And while that is part of the ROI, while that is part of the value of social media, I think there's a lot more I'll explain in this episode of the vlog. So when it comes to the value of social media, there is so much value beyond just the sale, beyond the conversion. So I work with a lot of nonprofits and they're looking to build a donor base and they're looking to raise money. Or I work with some small businesses and they're looking for sales. They're looking for new business leads. And all of those things are things that can come out of social media, but there's a lot more value that's there. And I believe there's four value opportunities for every organization that you could be thinking about of how you value social media. And at the end of the day, how you measure your ROI, the return on your investment, the return on your time, the return on your creativity, return on the financial investment you might make in advertising on social media. So let's dig into it a little bit. So the first value that I think everyone gets out of social media that invests time is introduction. So often I hear about how somebody found out about a brand, whether that was a nonprofit or a business or any kind of organization, it was by social media. So whether that was somebody else talking about it or somebody sharing a post from somebody else or them seeing an ad, is social media became the front door for that organization. Social media became the introduction that was made to that brand. And so it's rare that an actual purchase is made on social media, but it is very common that the introduction to the brand happen on social media. The second thing that I so often hear about social media and the value that comes out of the investment is perception. A lot of people, before they commit to a brand, whether that's buying a new car or going to a restaurant or attending a church service, they look on social media to see what they're about. Not just what that organization says about themselves, but what other people are saying about it as well. They're checking out reviews on Yelp or on Google or on Facebook. They're seeing what social media has to say about that organization. They honestly are even checking out how many followers do they have. And so basing the value or the perception is, you know what, if you have 3 followers on social media and you haven't posted in 2 years, you might not even be open. You might not be a real business or organization. So those that are heavily invested often create a perception before somebody connects with your organization. So whatever kind of organization you are, you're able to create a very unique first impression when it comes to somebody checking out your organization. So the value of that impression is very valuable from an investment perspective. Now, the third thing is what I shared at the beginning, and it is real. Conversion can happen on social media. So the third value is conversion. Now, a lot of times this is happening through advertising as you have direct response ads, and you can really do a lot of things like retargeting ads of people who engage with your content on social media, on Facebook and YouTube in particular, where you can retarget them and drive them to a landing page on your website or even have a purchase within a messenger bot on Facebook. And so there's a lot of direct conversion that can happen on Facebook, but it's normally a process. It's a value, it's a process of an introduction and the perception they have of your brand as they engage with you or as they check out your content, and then they have that conversion process. So it really is a process that rarely happens at the first point of contact, but it does happen oftentimes, and it's happening more and more through social media. As social media platforms are maturing, the opportunity for direct conversion from social media is increasing. And then the fourth value that I think is maybe the most valuable part, maybe I shouldn't even say maybe, that I believe is the most valuable part, is connection. Social media allows us to connect with people from an organizational perspective like never before. So if somebody buys something from our business, we're able to keep connecting with them and ask them how they thought it, share it with others and really engage with them and help show them how to better use it. So maybe it's a product for their home and we can teach them how to better use it in their home and have relationships with them, have interactive relationship. And it's often that whatever organization you're part of, whether that's a nonprofit or a business, that you want people to have an ongoing relationship. It's probably not just a one-time transaction that you're looking for. It's an ongoing relationship, and social media allows you to have that relationship in a very practical and a very real way, and it allows them to have a relationship with each other and grow and connect and build community around your organization. So the relationship aspect of social media is probably the the most valuable ROI of any aspect of social media. So as we wrap up this video, I want to invite you to connect with me. I want to be in relationship with you on social media. I'm at Nils Smith on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram. I'd love to connect with you on social media. I'd love to be in relationship with you and have an ongoing interaction. I'd love to connect with you in the comments. What are your thoughts? Are these the best ROI points that you would make for social media? Are there other things that I left out, other things that I missed, and other things that you measure to measure the value of your investment on social media? Thanks so much for watching.